Hi everyone, I'm Whitney from WhitneySews.com and today I'm going to be teaching you how to make continuous bias binding. And with this method you only have to sew two seams instead of sewing strips of fabric end to end to end. So it is a little bit simpler and it's just the method that I prefer, so that's what I'll be teaching you all today. There is a blog post that's going to be linked in the description box, and it will go over all of the math that you need to know to figure out how much fabric you'll need and to figure out how many inches of binding that will make for you so that you are able to make the amount that you need for your project and not end up with too short of a binding. And so definitely make sure to check out the blog post for all of that. So on to the actual project. You will start with a square of fabric, and the size does depend on the needed amount of bias tape using the math that I already mentioned that's on the blog. Cut your square in half from one corner to the other. If you have a yardstick, that will work great. If not, you can use two rulers butted up together like I show. You will end up with two equal triangles. Then line up the far left edge with the far right sides together. Pin the two layers together and sew with a 1/4 inch seam allowance. Open it up and iron the seam flat. The piece should now resemble a rhombus. On the back side of the fabric, begin marking lines as wide as you want your bias strips to be. The lines should all be parallel with the longer sides of the shape, with the seam going across at an angle. Once all the lines are marked, bring the two edges together. Instead of lining everything up even, offset it by one line. So the end of one side lines up with the first mark on the other side. Pin them together and make sure that when you trace along the line, it keeps spiraling around instead of forming several separate rings. Sew, then iron the seam open. Use a pair of scissors to carefully cut on your drawn lines. You now should have one long bias strip of fabric. At this point, you can use a bias tape maker to fold both edges in toward the center and iron, or you can simply fold it in half and iron. It depends on what you plan on using this for later. So here's actually the mini quilt that I made using my bias tape, and there will be a link to the full tutorial in the information icon in the upper corner of the screen as soon as it's posted. I hope this tutorial has been helpful. Don't forget to go over to WhitneySews.com for that blog post with all of the extra details. And that mini quilt tutorial that I mentioned will be up next Wednesday, so don't forget to subscribe and come back so you don't miss out on that. And until then, happy sewing. Bye.